Hashem will understand me. How do you know? What makes you so sure? There's a book of laws. You want to take your chances. That's not smart. Smart person for 1% chance that there's poison in his cup. 1%. There were 100 cups. You saw that one person put poison in one of them, mixed them all and ran away. And very thirsty. You didn't drink for 3 days. And now you want to drink. 1% chance that you die. 1%. And you won't drink. Say, you know what? Let me suffer another day until I get to safe water. Why? But you have headache. Your head is spinning. Why? I don't want to die. But it's only 1%. Come on. And maybe he lied. Maybe it's not really poison. So there's really 0.5%. 0.5% chance that you're going to die. And you're very thirsty. You don't want to suffer. I'll suffer another month if I have to. Why? I do not want to risk my life even by 0.5%. So why, when it's written in the Torah 12 times on Shabbat not to create fire, and it cuts the soul permanently from life of eternity, that's written a verse in the Torah, you willing to take such a risk? How can it be? There's no answer to this question. There's no logic here. Zero logic. Zero logic. Because the same person that you will show him in the Torah, that the Torah can never be written by a person. Never. That's why I brought you my books over there and some CDs. The CDs are free, the books are $20. It's worth the investment. You have many, many proofs over there, scientific proofs, one after the other. You can argue with the biggest atheist in the world, you crush him to pieces. Why? I don't have what to answer. The knowledge of the book, the name is divine information. Why? Information that's supplied by people, one day you can find that it was error. Maybe right now you think it's the truth, one day you'll find out a different truth. But what's divine, it will always remain the same. There's no room for errors. The word Bereshit in the beginning is the creation of material. From that second, the world began to run. And right after that, what happened right after that? Bereshit bara Elokim tashamayim v'taharetz, Hashem created heaven and earth. And everything was covered with water, and it was all dark. There's no light yet. Everything covered with water. There's raw material, rocks, there is water, there is earth, but it's all covered with water. And then the Torah began to describe how Hashem separated the water. Some of it he took up, some of it down, and that's Shamayim. Shamayim in Hebrew means Shamayim. Towards water over there, right? Sham, it means there, Mayim means water, right? And after that, after Hashem separated the water to one side, now Baruch Hashem, we have the land, one continent, one only. Later, it will break to 7 pieces. And it will become 7 continents. How many years later? About 1500 years later. When? In the flood of Noah. After God decided to clean all the wicked people from the face of the earth, and he cleaned all of them, he left Noah and his wife, his 3 sons and their 3 wives, 8 people. And the world restarted by a family of Noah. This was 4200 years ago. Water came from spring water, boiling water came, and with tremendous pressure, with 40 days non-stop pouring rain, just Wednesday, a few weeks ago, there was so much rain in New York, I almost died. I'll never forget this night. It was the biggest risk I've been in my life. First of all, I had a late night lecture in grade.